Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and many of you have asked me to share what's on my Mac, and so this is what's on my Mac early 2021. And so we'll start with the dock, and the dock is pretty straightforward. I don't keep a whole lot of things here. This is my main editing computer. It's a Mac Pro. You'll see more about that in a little bit. But you can see here, I just have Finder and LaunchPad, Safari, Google Chrome. Now I use Chrome only for a couple things. I use it mostly just to upload videos and handle doing things like that, since it seems to be a little bit better with handling that overall. Otherwise, I don't use Chrome a whole lot. I normally use Safari due to its privacy and security. Now, other than that, I'm using the stock mail app, messages, of course, and then Twitter to be on Twitter all day, and then photos, notes, music, and Final Cut Pro. Many of you have asked, what do I use to edit my videos? Well, normally I use Final Cut Pro. And then also I have some videos about Final Cut Pro if you want to learn how to get started and things like that. The app to the right of that is called Piezo. This is a simple application to record audio. So if I open it up here, this can actually record audio from whatever you're recording in. You'll see I recorded this audio for the iPhone 10 in 2021 app or video in this app. And it just, you hit record, it records from whatever source you choose, and you're good to go. Not a whole lot more to do with that, but that's all it does. It creates an MP3 file or whatever you set it to. So you'll see MP3 256 kilobit per second VBR. And then I'm recording this video with ScreenFlow. This is capturing the screen right now. It's making the cursor smoother, things like that. So that's what I'm recording the screen with. Now, before we go in and take a look at the LaunchPad and things like that, at the top I have a bunch of apps, and I get asked probably the most about these apps. So I'll start from right to left here. So this one is Magnet. This actually allows me to snap different windows to different areas. So if I open Safari, maybe we have Apple open and I want to snap that to the right. You can see here, Magnet lets me do that. I can bring it out, snap it to the full screen, to the left, and just have it sort of separate the screen that way. And it's easy to use. So you just click on it and you can change any of the configurations on it. It's in the App Store and it's definitely worth checking out if you want to sort of organize your windows, especially if you have an ultra wide monitor or a very large monitor. This is a Pro Display XDR that's 32 inches. So I like to organize things like that. It just makes it a little easier. The next one is called AirBuddy. This is an application that's very simple, gives you your status of all your different devices. When you want to connect, say your AirPods, for example, it measures that. It's even telling me my iPad Pro status. So it's pretty simple there. And if we go to settings, you'll see it says AirBuddy. So you can enable it. It looks at the system. You can increase the battery indicator font size. It will show you if you're close to it with AirPods, for example, and if you want to connect, you can click a window. So it's a really helpful utility. It just adds to what you have. So you've got my keyboard and trackpad and iPad, iPhone and iPhone 12. Anything that's nearby and reporting back their status, it'll let you know. The next is for remote desktop. It's called Screens Connect. I don't really use it that often, but it's there if I want to use it. I have a little 1Password helper, but then to the left of that, here is a status of all of the different things on my computer, from the GPU temperatures to the different PCIe slot temperatures to the memory temperatures and things like that. So this is an interesting app. We can go to more. You can see more about it. It's called TG Pro, this particular app. And there's some others I'm using as well. I probably have too many of these, but you can see the different fans. You can flip them to max if you want to spin them up faster. You can put them on auto, or we can put them back to system. So it's really nice. You can adjust that as need be. This is for color calibration. I don't really use this right now, so I'll actually exit it. So I don't know why that's starting, but here we have what's called iStat menu. And this is actually telling me a bunch of information from my solid state drive, because we're recording right now, it's using it heavily. So I'm recording to that drive and you can see it here, everything that's being written to the drive, and how much is free. I should empty this a little bit as I have a 4 terabyte drive. Video takes up a lot. So here we have memory. It tells what's in use. As you can see here, there is almost 80 gigabytes of RAM free. Then here are the CPUs. This is a 16 core CPU, Mac Pro. So it tells all of that information. And then you've got all of that. Now up here is part of iStat menu, and this is actually giving me my temperatures of everything. So similar to what the other app over here did, where I was showing you temperatures before, right here, this is actually doing the same sort of thing, telling me my CPU core proximity 3 temperature, all the way to my SSD temperatures, and then the fans in the Mac. So you've got the blower fan, the bottom fan, middle fan, and top fan, and then of course my CPU frequency. So all of that is included here. And again, it's all part of iStat menu. Now, my favorite application for monitoring your Mac and seeing more about it is called Sensei, and that can be found in LaunchPad. So if I go into the LaunchPad, you'll see here we have all my different apps we'll go over in a moment, but here's Sensei. So this application is one of my favorites for telling what's going on with your Mac. So not only does it give the name, it has a nice little visual representation of the Mac you're using. It even tells the origin of where it was made and when it was manufactured. So it's got all of that information. Then it shows you the SSD, your CPUs, the dual GPUs that I have, and the RAM pressure, how much is being used basically. So I have 96 gigs of RAM in this, and it's really nice that it's there. So it's got all of that information. And if we go over to optimize, you can do things like optimize different items. You can see your storage, click on it, it gives you more information. You can benchmark it, see more about the storage. It's really in depth and it's not very expensive. But as you can see here, there's the display, even showing the wallpaper that's on the display, the two graphics cards, and more. So there's lots of information here. If you really like to dig down deep into this, see all the fans, things like that, you can see even the power supply temperature. So it's got all of that information, and it's one of my favorite apps for that. Now, in the Launchpad, I do have some other apps as well. This is my main editing machine, so I don't do a whole lot of gameplay or anything like that, but I do have a couple things. So as you can see here, Pixelmator Pro, that's what I usually use for thumbnails and things like that. That's the application that I create my thumbnails in, and I've used it for many, many years. It's an alternative to Photoshop. It's inexpensive. You pay for it once, not monthly, and as long as it does everything you need it to, it's faster than Photoshop in many things, and it's probably the best one out there for me anyway. So we have Motion and Compressor. These go along with Final Cut Pro. I don't use them too often, but I have them if needed. And then Firefox is a separate browser. It's just a backup. I don't really use it that often, but sometimes to test things I do. So if you go through these next rows here, you won't see anything really exciting. Just Intel Power Gadget, that has to be installed for some of these monitoring apps to work. iStat menu, like I said, and these are benchmarking applications. Blackmagic Disk Speed Test, Cinebench, and Heaven here are all benchmarking applications, along with Geekbench up at the top. As we get closer to the bottom, you'll see a few other things like Telegram, iMazing, Discord, and then Amazon Music. I don't really use that anymore, but it's just there. And SoftRaid I have installed because I was testing a different drive inside this computer. I have a separate video on that from last year. I probably should uninstall this. The same is true for Google Chrome and Google Hangouts and Play and things like that. These two don't really need to be here, but they are. And then M Installer are effects that I use for Final Cut Pro. So when you see different menus and things, they actually pop in all of those different effects and things. So it's a plugin for Final Cut Pro. Now, if we go over one, you'll see that I have Android file transfer. So if I need to move some photos off of Android phones, for example, iZip, I don't even know why I have it. I probably should uninstall it. The same is true for Bitdefender virus scanner. I don't really need that. It's just something that's here. I check out for people when they're asking me questions about things. Hype4 is for making HTML5 animations for websites. I don't really use it a whole lot, but it's there. And then Don't Sleep is something I use a lot to stop my display from going to sleep or stopping the computer from going to sleep. It's free in the App Store, and you can see, put it on Don't Sleep, it won't go to sleep. And you can say forever or how long, have it start at login and things like that. So something I use quite often when I'm recording videos. And then of course I have TweetDeck, I don't really use too often. VLC and Handbrake if I need to convert files. I don't use them often, but they're here. App Cleaner to actually clean apps. And then Catalyst Browse is for Sony cameras. It actually helps with different footage on Sony cameras with stabilization and things like that. FX Factory and Echo Remover, these are things I don't really use, but they're built-in plugins for Final Cut Pro. They sell things like that. And then camera settings for my webcam. So I actually have a webcam in my office. Let's see if I can get it to work here. See if it'll open. There we go. You can see the office here a little bit without me being centered or anything like that. I can move this up or down. And I have the light off while recording this, but I think you get the idea. So let me go ahead and close that. And then that's really it. This is not really a packed computer when it comes to anything else. It's a very focused editing computer is what I use it for. So if I'm editing anything for videos for YouTube, this is what I'm using. I use it for social media and that's about it. It's not for gaming. It does have that one game on here, Sid Meier Railroads, which I've played many times in the past, but I rarely use that. And it's just for the occasional break if I want it. But other than that, there's not much more to talk about. That's every single thing on my Mac Pro. So not a whole lot more to talk about with it. But hopefully that helped you out deciding if any of these apps are right for you. Some of them are free. Some of them are not. iStat Menu and Sensei is not free, but I think they're well worth the $10 to $15 cost and you never have to buy it again. So it's pretty reasonable there. But let me know if there's any apps you think I should check out. I'd love to check them out. Let me know in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper if you're interested in having it on your Mac as well. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.